show, we are inventing great items for pets, solving everyday problems for the world's lovable, huggable, kissable, cleanupable pets. And now it's time to meet our next pet inventor, who's got something up their sleeve, or brain, as it were. Wait, you have something up your brain? I want to get that looked at. Say hello, be lucky not to, Jordan! Hey, Jordan, how are you?
Good.
Great, wait, it sounds very quiet. Are you no longer in Universal Studios?
Nope.
Oh, where are you now, Jordan?
At my puppy's house.
Oh, you're at your Bubby's house!
We just got home from Universal.
Yeah.
You're in the car.
You're having a driveway moment at Bubby's house. Just got home from Universal. Jordan, break it down for us. This is like Tours with Jordan, the radio program. Tell us, Jordan, what was it like? How was your experience today?
Good.
What'd you do?
So, I went on the Spider-Man ride.
Oh, you did! Excellent, okay. I didn't even know there was a Spider-Man ride until you told me yesterday. Jordan, what is the Spider-Man ride? Like, how's it work? What do you do on the ride?
So you sit, in this car, and then,
you put glasses on,
and then you get in the ride. But then Spider-Man gets in the front and says hello. But then all the villains get in the front so they can be bad and do bad stuff in the front.
Oh, I see. Got it. But they're villains and they do bad stuff, but they do it in order so that at least they're orderly about their bad doing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's good. Fun. Okay, and did you have, a fast pass type experience for that, or did you have to wait in line for a long time?
Nope.
Didn't have to wait in line?
It's so cold here, too. It's 50 degrees here.
50 degrees. That's... Oh, boy. You hear that, Wisconsin and Minnesota? It's really cold in Florida, too. It's 50 degrees. My gosh. People are... all the stores of Florida are completely empty of light sweaters. There are no long sleeves left anywhere. Okay, so there weren't many people there. That's good news for you, Jordan. And since you're from Massachusetts, you're used to colder temperatures, so 50 degrees was no big deal for you, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, great! Oh, perfect. You're snowbirding at Universal Studios. Well, Jordan, it's time now to unveil your pet invention. What do you have for us?
My daddy wished that, a fish bowl could clean itself.
Oh, that's a good one! Do you have a fish? Do you guys have a family fish?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
So I take it that you have some experience cleaning the fish bowl. Jordan, do you ever have to clean that fish bowl?
Nope.
No? Oh, okay. So for you, this couldn't matter, doodly to you. You don't care. But for people who do clean a fish bowl, this could be a game changer. How does this fishbowl cleaner work? How does it clean itself, Jordan?
It scrubs.
Oh, okay. It's got self-scrubbers. Very nice. Is it kind of
so
a windshield?
Daddy doesn't have to scrub it.
Well, yeah, he's getting older now. I heard that he's 37 now. That's a big deal. You gotta watch your sciatica, and you gotta make sure to watch out for carpal tunnel at the ripe old age of 37. I remember that 5 years ago. So, Jordan, is it kind of like a windshield wiper type situation? Like you click on the wipers and they just kind of clean off the ball from the inside?
Yeah.
Oh, that's great. Perfect. I think fish deserve to have a clean environment. That's why I invented something, too. Did you hear about my invention, Jordan?
Nope.
Okay. This is great. We could sell these together as a two-pack. We could have your fishbowl cleaner, or self-cleaning fishbowl, and mine, my invention is goldfish barf bags. So, if a goldfish gets seasick, and it's gonna, throw up in the water, because the goldfish is looking a little green in the gills, you can just give it a barf bag, and it can throw up in the bag instead of throwing up in the water. That's a good idea, right, Jordan?
Yeah.
Very good.